we all have a responsibility to our environment. If this is the oldest living continuing culture on the planet, then it's our responsibility collective to look after it, to make sure it's around for the next 60,000 years. You know? And so educating the broader community about some of this stuff is really, really important. Hello, I'm Phil Rist. I'm a senior Ngawagi traditional owner from around the Ingham area. And I'm also the CEO of the Girringun Aboriginal Corporation, but also the Process Unite, which is another initiative, Process Unite coordinator with the organisation. I really want to acknowledge the Wurrugaba people of the land that we stand on now. It's customary that I do that as a neighbouring traditional owner group, I really want to acknowledge them as a traditional custodians of this land and thank them very much for me being here, allowing me to be on their country. We're building this a boardwalk through the mangroves and out through, I won't say the name of the park or anything, but onto some sand dunes. Where the end of the boardwalk stopped, and then the path went through the sand dune. The designated park path that they built went through the middle of a midden, and I didn't really like that. And so that was a moment that I thought, hang on, you know, this is all well and good, but now we have a Aboriginal site here. So my Aboriginal hat, if you like, came on, and then I started to question why we're doing this and we shouldn't be doing it. We should be taking the track around somewhere else and that. And so I think that was a point where I started thinking about my traditional owner obligations to the country, and that shifted. And so I became a lot more involved in that side of things. And that was the beginning of the end for me to exit from that part over to becoming where I am now. There was a number of things going on at the same time, I reckon, when Seaform became this body. ATSIC was still around, land councils were there, of course, there was some leadership around at the time from saltwater people, and some of those leaders were Melissa George and Bob Muir and Vince Mundraby and a few others as well. And we all just came together and we started thinking about how we could, and this is my time now with Girringun, so we just came together and we started, we had some support, a lot of support from JCU and CSIRO and others as well, and lending support in a way as administration and money and ideas and so forth. So that started forming the nucleus of Seaform. We are managing right now by ourselves our take of turtle and dugong. Before that was managed by somebody else, but we're doing that now, and we have the sole responsibility, and that's where it should be, with traditional owners managing their take of turtle and dugong. Under our tumra, we make the decision who hunts, we make the decision how many they take, and we make the decision of where they take them from. And then we let the Great Barrier Reef Park Authority know, and their responsibility then is to let agencies know that Girringun has just issued an authority to hunt a turtle and dugong in their country. So I think we're at the point where we can't sole manage things all by itself, but we can have a mixture of co-management here and we can have a sole management here. It is everybody's responsibility to manage that sea country, particularly traditional owners, but we can't do it by ourselves. And parks can't do it by ourselves, marine parks can't do it, or grump or fisheries or anybody else with it. So it demands partnerships between us, and that's, for me, that's sharing ownership and stewardship and everything else of this magnificent marine park that we have in our backyard, you know. So it's, and but then soil management stuff, there's some things that we can do by ourselves, and but again being supported by our partners. I think if we can get there, I think we're really well and truly on the right track. So for me, the aspiration is to seeing our younger ones stepping up and taking the ball further, if you like. But we've got to leave it in a good place so that they can do that stuff, you know. And how we do that, that's a challenge, a real challenge, because, you know, there's a lot of things that our younger people are much more interested in at the moment than that. You might have a, you'll always have a pool of our young people that want to do this sort of stuff, but we've got to really embrace more and implement initiatives and projects and all this sort of stuff and training so that we can bring the younger ones on board, you know. And just to saturate our country with our presence and managing all aspects of managing country, land and sea country. That would be, because that's the aspirations that those guys had that I talk about many years ago. It's we've carried that legacy or that aspirations to a point now. We're developing that. It's our time now to create our own legacy, and that legacy for the next generations to go forward and carry that stuff forward. So, yeah, for me it would be really cool to see our younger ones stepping up and taking on the role and becoming the new managers.